morning students. Today we have studied the main part of the lesson. Today's date is 29 2020. Today's date is 29 September 2020. Class is 8 PM. Day is 2. Meaning and types of economy. Last day we studied about capitalist economy. What is the meaning of capitalist economy? We studied last day. Today we have to study about socialist economy. What is the meaning of or what is meant by socialist economy that we have learned? What is the meaning of and what is meant by socialist economy that we have learned? Socialist economy. Russia, China, Romania, Czechoslovakia, all these nations are following socialism. What are the features of socialism that we are in? What is mean by socialism or what are the features of socialism that we are studying? First of all, collective ownership. When we are studying what is meaning of collective ownership, we will be able to know what is meaning of socialism. Last day we studied that in capitalist economy, industries, agriculture, trade, commerce, transport, communication, etc. are under the control of private individuals. In a capitalist economy, government will not interfere unnecessarily. In capitalist economy, government will not interfere unnecessarily. But in socialism, the case is different. In a socialist economy, the case is fully different. In socialism, collective ownership is the speciality of socialism. That means industries, agriculture, trade, commerce, transport, communication, etc. will be under the control of the government. Government will control everything. Everything will be under the control of the society. Everything will be under the control of the society. Such a system is known by the name socialism. Private industries and private agriculture field, private trade and commerce, private transport and communication will not be there in a socialist economy. So, collective ownership is the speciality of socialism. Then, social welfare objective. What is the speciality of capitalism? That's what I told you. What are there in capitalism? What is the speciality of capitalism that I have told you? Profit motive is the main objective of capitalism. All the capitalist industries, trade and commerce, transport and communication, is working only for making profit. Profit motive is the main objective of capitalism. Without getting profit, in capitalism, nobody will do any economic activity. In capitalism, all the activities are done with an idea to make profit. But in socialism, the case is different. All the industries, agriculture, is under the government. Government is undertaking everything. Why government is undertaking everything? Government is undertaking everything for the welfare of the society. Only for the welfare of the society. Government is doing everything. Only for the happiness of our society. Only for the welfare of the society or only for the happiness of the society. Everything is undertaken by the government. Social welfare of the team. Happiness of the society will be the main idea of the government. Government is starting agriculture field, industries, trade and commerce. Members of the society. Central planning. What is the meaning of planning? I have told you several times. What is planning? Planning means to act with a purpose. When we are doing something with an idea in mind, that is known as planning. When we are doing something with an idea in our mind is known as planning. That is the meaning of planning. So what is that? In a socialist economy, central planning is a must. Government will find out how much money is there in the economy. Government will find out how much money is there in the economy. And how many resources items are there, that also government will find out. This is known as planning. So planning means to act with a purpose is known as planning. To act with a purpose is known as planning. Central planning is the most important specialty of socialist economy. Or in all the socialist economies, what is that? In all the socialist economies, central planning is the role. Central planning is a must in all the socialist economies. Other countries of the world, now other countries of the world are following socialist planning. Then reduction in inequalities. In capitalism, we can see, in capitalism, in a capitalist economy, we can see two types of people. In capitalism, in a capitalist economy, we can see two types of people. They are rich people and poor people. Rich people are the owners of industries. They are the owners of agriculture land. They are the owners of trade, transport and communication. At the same time, poor people are there. Poor people. Poor people are the workers. Poor people. Poor people are the workers. Poor people do not have any money with them. Rich people have more money with them. But what is that? In a socialist economy of In socialism, such inequalities are not there. There is no difference between rich people and poor people. All are same. This is the speciality of which one? This is the speciality of socialism. Next one. No cross conflict. In capitalism, rich people are there and poor people are there in capitalism. In capitalism, in capitalist economy, rich people and poor people are there. They are always fighting. But in socialism or in a socialist economy, such a type of or such a kind fight or fight, he is not there. In socialism or in socialist economy, such a type of fights are not there. All people are equal. There is no need of fighting between rich people and poor people. All are same. These are the specialities of or features or characteristics of socialist economy. Then we are studying on mixed economy. What is the meaning of mixed economy, or what is mean by mixed economy? We are studying. What is the meaning, or what is the speciality of mixed economy? The meaning and speciality of mixed economy we have said. What is that? The first feature or the first speciality of mixed economy is that in a mixed economy, public and private sectors are working side by side. This is an important speciality of mixed economy. Or in a mixed economy, private sector and public sector. In a mixed economy, private sector and public sector, they are working together. What I told about capitalism? In a capitalist economy, what is that? In a capitalist economy, public sector and private sector is not there. In capitalism, only private sector is there. In capitalism. In capitalism, only private sector is there. In capitalism. In capitalism, only private sector is there. All the industries, all the agriculture, trade, commerce, transport, and communication will be under the control of private developers. Government will not be having more power. Government will not have, or government may not have more role. That is capitalism. But in socialism, what is it? In the land of socialism, just opposite is happening in socialism. Ulta or just opposite is happening in the land of socialism. What is it? In the land of socialism, only public industries are there. Only public agriculture land is there. Government trade and commerce, government transport, there is a speciality of which one? There is a speciality of this one, socialism. But mixed economy is a mixture of some things. Mixed economy is a mixture of some things. What are the public industries are there and private industries are there in mixed economy. In a mixed economy, public industries are there at the same time. Private industries are also there. So, public industries and private industries are there in the mixed economy. Both are standing on, both are existing side by side. That is the speciality of mixed economy. Then, another speciality is there for mixed economy. In a mixed economy, individual freedom is there. In a mixed economy, sir, in a mixed economy, individual freedom is there. In a capitalism, what is it? In socialism and capitalism, people do not have more freedom. In capitalism, private individuals are deciding everything in capitalism. In capitalism, private individuals or private persons are doing everything in capitalism. But in socialism, what is that? In socialism, what is happening? In socialism, government is deciding everything. but this is not the case in mixed economy. ये mixed economy private industries are there. At the same time, public industries are also there. So, ये mixed economy consumers and common people they do have maximum freedom. Another speciality of mixed economy is that economic prime is an important speciality of mixed economy. Economic prime is an important feature of it is an important speciality of mixed economy. Economic prime. This is a speciality of socialism. What I told you in socialism or in socialist economy, in socialist economy, what is the planning is the arranging the resources and money in a correct way is known as planning. Arranging the resources and money in a correct way is known by what name? Planning. Arranging the resources and money in a good way or a correct way is known by what name? It is known by the name prime. Then what is that? That speciality is there in mixed economy also. In mixed economy also, economic prime is there. India is the best example of mixed economy. India is the best example of mixed economy. In India, what is actually happening? Resources are arranged in a better way. We are allocating the money in a mixed economy. In a mixed economy, we are allocating the money and we are arranging the resources in a mixed way, in a good way. So economic prime is there in mixed economy. Price mechanism. What is that? The price of necessary items will be decided by demand and supply. Demand is coming from the side of consumers. Supply is coming from the side of producers. When the demand is more, what is it? When the demand is more, price of the items will increase. When price is more, supply will increase. What are the types of economy on the basis of development? On the basis of development, what is that? How we can divide the economy on the basis of development? We can divide the economy into two categories. One is developed economy. America, Britain, France, Japan, China, Italy, Spain, America, all these nations are the best example of developed economy. In a developed economy, what is it? In a developed economy, high per capita income will be there. Per capita income means income of the people. Income of one person per capita means per capita. Per capita means income of one person in 1 year is known as per capita. In developed countries, what is that? In developed countries, income of one person in 1 year will be high national income. In a developed economy, income of the nation in 1 year will be more. National income means income of the nation in 1 year. In a developed economy, national income of such a country will be more. High capital formation. What is the meaning of capital value? Capital is the basic money of capital is a fundamental money which we are using in any economic field. Usage of capital in any economic field is known as investment. So, the total capital formation, the total capital formation in any country in developed economy is more. So, capital formation in developed countries are more. Saving is the money which you are keeping aside without spending. Saving also will be more in a developed economy. Second type of economy is called developing economy or underdeveloped countries. Developing economy or underdeveloped countries. What is the meaning of this one? Developing. Those countries which are non-developed, but they are moving towards development. These countries are not actually developed, but these countries are moving towards development. Such countries are known by what name? Such nations or such countries are known by the name developing countries or underdeveloped countries. Underdeveloped countries are having the features which are just opposite of developing countries. In developing countries,
socialism. ये सोशलिस्ट इकोनॉमी कलेक्टिव ओनरशिप इज द कलेक्टिव ओनरशिप व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ दिस वन विदाउट फ्रीडम दैट मींस इन सोशलिस्ट इकोनॉमी और इन सोशलिज्म इंडस्ट्रीज आर ओन्ड बाय गवर्नमेंट ओन्ड इंडस्ट्रीज आर अंडर द कंट्रोल ऑफ गवर्नमेंट इन सोशलिज्म ओन्ड द एग्रीकल्चर लैंड विल बी अंडर द कंट्रोल ऑफ गवर्नमेंट ट्रेड कॉमर्स ट्रांसपोर्ट कम्युनिकेशन एक्सेट्रा विल बी अंडर द कंट्रोल ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट नथिंग विल बी देयर अंडर द कंट्रोल ऑफ प्राइवेट पर्सन्स दिस इज नोन एज कलेक्टिव ओनरशिप Next one is social welfare of the team. What is the main idea of industrial owners? In capitalism, yesterday I heard you. In capitalism, industrial owners are starting industries only for making profit. But in socialism, industrial owners are starting industries are not there in socialism all the industries agriculture land trade commerce transport and communication are under the control of government so profit motive is not the main idea of socialism the main idea of socialism is to increase the happiness of Government don't want money. Increasing the happiness of the people is the main idea of socialism. Central plan. In socialism, what is that? In socialism or in the socialist economy, central plan is the central plan. What is the meaning of this one? That is the thing. In socialism or in the socialist economy government will find out how many resources are there or how much resources are there in the country how much money is there in the country and they will find out the money and resources after finding the money and resources what they will do after finding the money and the resources government will make prime then reduction in inequalities in capitalism equality is not there equality is equal samana in capitalism rich people are there and poor people are there inequality is there but in socialism inequality is not there in a socialist economy no class conflict is there in capitalism rich people and poor people they are always fighting their interests are different in capitalism or in capitalist economy rich people and poor people are always fighting but in socialism there is no class conflict no class conflict is there in socialism there is no rich and poor in socialism there is no question of war there is no difference between rich people and poor people what I say there is no difference between rich people and poor people what are seeing then we have to study what is mixed economy mixed you are purchasing mixture from the baker mixture you are purchasing from the baker what is the meaning sir in the mixture so many items will be there this mixture so mixed economy is a mixture of public and private sector in capitalism what is that in capitalism or in capitalist economy what is there that is working in capitalism only agriculture trade and commerce will be under the control of government but mixed economy is a mixture of private and public industries both are there there is a specialty of mixed economy both government industries government stores government colleges government agriculture and government transport and communication is there in mixed economy at the same time private stores private colleges private industries private agriculture and will be there in mixed economy so mixed economy is a mixture of private and public sector so mixed economy is a mixture of private and public sectors individual freedom in a mixed economy individual freedom is there in mixed economy this is a specialty of mixed economy in capitalism and socialism individual freedom is not there that much but in mixed economy individual freedom is there then economic planning economic planning is a specialty of socialism in socialism economic planning is there same method we are following in mixed economy in mixed economy also economic planning is there government is finding out or government will find out how much money is there in the country or government will find out how much resources is there in the mixed economy then government of a mixed economy government of a mixed economy is doing economic planning government of a mixed economy is doing economic planning so economic planning is an important specialty of mixed economy price mechanism price mechanism is a mechanism in which price vary prices of items are decided by demand and supply that is mixed economy when the demand is more price increases when price is more industry owners will provide more items in the market so price mechanism is an important specialty of mixed economy then we have named what are the types of economy what are the major or what are the types of economy on the basis of development on the basis of development how we can divide the countries on the basis of development we can divide the countries into two they are developed economy and developing economy that in a developed economy high per capita income is there what is the meaning of per capita income that is out there per capita income means income of people income of one person in one year per capita is per capita so in a developed economy what is that in a developed economy per capita income of people are more all the people will be having more income high national income what is that in a developed economy income of the nation in one year is too much high capital formation what is the meaning of capital productivity capital is the amount of money capital is the amount of money which we are using in economic field economic investment that is capital the total use of capital money in each and every field in a developed economy is more second one developing economy
India? What is their diversity? India is not developed, no doubt. India is not at all developed. But at the same time, India is not underdeveloped. India is moving towards development. That is developing economy. So, on the basis of development, what is that? Countries of the world can be divided into two. They are developed economy and developing economy or underdeveloped countries. I think, children, you are able to.